Hello there everyone, and welcome back to this 100 Years War mod for Mount and Blade. So, we haven't yet to be able to declare war on the British, or the English at this time. We're still at war with the Burgundians. They soon will have nothing left. But right now, my castle, my main castle, is under siege by the forces of Britain. So, we'll have to go on the walls and prepare to defend our town. We can also take a look here. This is what we currently have against the Burgundians. So the Burgundians still have 4 castles and 2 towns, I believe. No, they got one more there. Right, here we go. Here's the battle. Let's try to defend our town. The attack during the night. Although I do think we'll have a pretty good chance of winning this. I've picked up this. I went over to the place where you can get new kinds of arms in... I think it's an English... It's controlled by the English now, I think, maybe. So I've got this one. It's pretty good. If you're able to hit. Let's see if we can't. Thirty damage only. Once more. There we go. 69 damage. Pretty good. There, I think I took one out. Yeah. Fire your guns! Not entirely sure what he screams there. Sometimes he says he says something when he fires. Putain! Not entirely sure what that means. Probably a swear. Putain! It's a thing apparently. I guess it's sort of, you know, I'm. Here goes nothing, because this thing might explode in my hand. Or maybe it's a requirement that you say it every time you fire this sort of arquebus, or what you would call it, culverine. I think they call it culverinists. It's the unicorn. No, arquebus here. Puto! Puto! It's pretty good though that I'm able to take out. We got 7 of these guys present on the battlefield somewhere. Oh, I thought I was out of ammo. Puto! It's going quite dreadful for the Bretonians, I guess. Puto! And there I'm out of ammo. Maybe one of the other guys has been taken down. See about picking up their weapon. Although there's only about, whether that's 10, only about 25 people have been taken down on our side, while 170 is taken down on the enemy side. You can just see all the green as they're being cut down. There are multiple ladders on this map. There's one there, and then there's one across over there, but the AI want to take the shortened route, and so they're cut down in the hundreds. Oh, let's see if we can pick up your cartridges. Yes, I'm not sure. My arquebus is probably better. We can continue screaming PUCHO at the enemy. Oh, there's another one somewhere over there. PUCHO! That was a headshot. Delivered 200 damage. PUCHO! Let's see doing it like this. There's no way I'm gonna miss this, so... PUCHO! That was a headshot, and I didn't even look. Well, this is gonna take a while, so... how about I'll get back to you guys when the battle is almost over. We're about to win this. Because at this rate, we're gonna have to take down, I think, another 250 men, something. Actually, they'll probably, since there's so many, they'll probably, we'll probably have to kill like 500. And then we have to attack out, and we'll go to that battle, or just before. Anyways, there's no point in watching this slow grind, meat grinder of Burgundians. No, not Burgundians. The Bretonians marching up, getting killed in their hundreds. Oh, that man flew away. Right. And there we go. That's the last guy. Woohoo! And our losses amount to 21 soldiers dead, 30 men wounded. The enemy's losses are 462 dead and 162 wounded. Right, most likely now. Yeah, the enemy has been forced to retreat. The assault is over, but the siege continues. So they have about maybe 400 men or something like that. So we'll take everyone in the garrison and then we'll move out and attack them. Kaboom! You'll be hearing of me a lot. Surrender or die. So we've got 361 troops fit for battle against their 367. So they outnumber us only by 6 men. So it's a quite even battle. Let's see here. I'll do it like this. It's probably easier. Still gonna be a hell of a fight, but at this point, since I've been in war with the Burgundians so long, most of my men I've been able to upgrade to French macemen, and they're pretty bloody good. Plus, they knock the enemy unconscious, which means that I take them prisoner. I didn't even realize I had this many, but that's also why I'm sort of running out of money as well, because my towns give me so little cash. Right, there's nothing for it. I also noticed that I didn't actually go offline, as you could see someone adding me there on Steam. Archers to me. Cavalry charge, infantry charge. Shot his horse underneath him. They're not standing a chance in field battle either. Ooh, that's quite quickly. We're knocking tons of them unconscious by all the macemen I have.
We are the macemen.
New enemies have arrived. Most of the other enemies are routing, so let's concentrate our troops back together again. Let the archer and the cavalry take care of the routing troops, and we'll prepare to face the second force. Macemen, hold! Oh, that bastard didn't even die when I shot him. Charge in! Slay them! Everyone, charge! Well, this was a quite good start to this war, taking out the Bretonians' army right in the start here. That can't be one of ours, can it? I don't have any crappy guy. Oh yeah. We've lost 10 wounded, 7 killed at this point. And now the last remaining force of the enemy is running away. We'll have to fight them again though, so we get all of them. There's only one guy left. Woohoo! It's a great start to this war. I understand why the English don't want to declare war on us. Because of my skill in tactics and the fact that I think we're starting to outnumber them now, I've been able to have 160 men on the field while the enemy only have 93. See if I can shoot someone with this range. Got another horse. It looks like some of the cavalry is just banditry. Charge, macemen! Cavalry, charge in! Oh, we overrun that force pretty darn quickly. Don't worry about this guy, I'll get him. Turn back to the front. We got a second cluster of enemies coming in. Let's break up this cluster of archers. Right, right, right. And the enemy is retreating. That was probably the last attack of them. So we'll have cut down their entire army. Or most of them at least. Wahey! Very good battle. Now we'll station... Oh yeah, I'm running out of money quite quickly. Maybe I shouldn't upgrade some of these. And then we'll put the macemen. We had 50 in, and then 50 French crossbowmen as garrison. And then let's see if there's a ransom broker here today. No, it's a traveler. Since we're losing money so quickly, we'll have to see about finding one of those, what's it called? Ransom brokers. There we go. Maybe we should go, oh, not that one. Right. So we go quite quickly and get a lot of money, so. But then, after that, we'll head over and take a look at either of these castles and see if we can't attack them and put pressure on the Bretonians or the Bretons. And soon we'll actually be able to push, I think we can push these out, and we'll push the Burgundians out quite quickly as well. And then it's just the English. And hopefully the King of France actually goes ahead and declares war on someone rather than being the other way all the time when the enemy declares war on us. But right now I'll go back and forth and pick up the troops and sell them here. I managed to get quite a good penny for the troops that I sold. I checked this one out and we have to build a siege tower for that one, so I'd rather go for something that... it's a lot easier to attack, so this one we should get quite easily. Right. Also, two of the troops in this one were actually some of the people I've... Ooh. Interesting. Right, we'll move actually the infantry up high, and then we'll have the crossbowmen there. Arquebus in the back. The cavalry will also move behind the main infantry line. I think with the position like this, we should be able to shoot down quite a lot of them with the crossbowmen before we go in. Because there is about 200 men holding the castle, I think it was. Some of them are trying to escape falling off the wall. Let's go close and see if we can't take him out. Ah, crap. No, I am in the focus. Maybe tell the crossbowmen to come closer. Actually, if they can come up here, and they can fire from here, they'll fire in from an angle, so they'll get the guy standing like that. So they'll get at all the angles of the enemy. Oh, that should be pretty easy to shoot those guys down. I'm losing a lot of health. Losing a lot more people since the archers are firing at each other now. Let's see if we can get the first enemy reinforcement to spawn in, and then we'll send in the troops. A lot of the enemy crossbowmen, I mean a lot of the enemy archers, have been taken down at this point. Which will make it a lot easier for my troops to charge in. One last shot. Right, let's send them in. Infantry charge! Cavalry charge! Up the ladder! The only one that we placed there. Took us 2 hours to place it. So you... Where are you guys going? Suddenly it became very quiet. No one's firing at each other. Very, very quiet. But as soon as they get up, yeah. Bah! Now enemy reinforcements turned up. But that's the last they get, so they have 152 men we need to take out. Come on, push your way through. Can someone shoot that archer? Right, now we got people coming in properly. Heavy fighting going up on up there. Now there's a chance for me to go up. Archers, I want you to spread out a bit so when the reinforcements come in, they can run through you. Ah! looks like there's a lot less enemies down to this side. Oh. No! Damn it! I was taken down. Crap. You managed to clear out that side. Oh. They're sort of teleporting off the ramp here. Well, we haven't lost that many men. So I think if we go at it a second time, we should be able to do that and take the castle. I could let the troops now attacking go in and kill them off, but I want to lead it through the this time around. Oh crap. I need aid! Oopsie! Well, I should have known that wasn't gonna go well. Right, so there's only these two guys left. But I do believe once we'll actually retreat that they will be taken down. So I don't think we'll have to attack the castle just for two more soldiers holding it. Haha! You are my prisoner now. And we lost a lot of men, but we're able to resupply by all the prisoners. There's quite a lot of them. I'm not gonna take any of these guys. I want only fringe troops in my army. We got some more of these things we can sell. And actually, right now I'm losing money from all the bloody castles I have, so we will not ask it as a reward. However, maybe I should hold on or try to hold on to it. We'll actually go over now and check this one. Probably should attack this before those two lords there get any ideas about charging out. So let's besiege this, build a siege tower. Hopefully we'll get someone to come over here and help us protect that. Kingdom of England has declared war on France! Then we do not care about the Bretonians anymore. We must back to Bourges to probably protect it against a English army. And then we'll go on to attack the English. This means that right now France is at war with all three factions. This might be bad, because this might give time for the Burgundians to pull back. It looks like they've actually taken back... we had taken this, I think. So they've taken that one back. We'll wait here for some time and see where the enemy is going to strike, where the English are going to come. there's a medium-sized group of enemies spotted near that castle. There's a significant group of enemies coming over the bridge there at Orléans. And they're most likely coming this way. Soon we'll see English on the horizon. Yep, here they come. And there's tons of them this time around. Ooh, I'm gonna hold out against all of these. Look at all these lords. Holy crap. I've got 323 men in my party. And then we got an extra 100 men in the castle. It's gonna be hard. This is gonna be a hard battle for sure. Wonder how many bloody English there are. There's a lot of 50 and a lot of 100, so there might not be that many, but I'm guessing we got English King in there somewhere. Not entirely sure how many men he's got in his party. If we can try to find it. Because I remember the King of England had quite a lot of troops. Right, we'll have to hopefully there's not that many of them. Maybe 1,000. Maybe a bit more than 1,000. Maybe 1,500. There's 2,640 English! Where do they get all of these troops from? No one else has anything close to this. Holy crap. That means each one of our troops has to kill 5 English, I think. If I'm counting correctly. Oh yeah, I've removed those things. Right. There we go. And this, we're not up to a great start because of those bloody English longbowmen. Ah! Sneaky English are actually getting through that way. This is going to be a hell of a battle. Since they've got 2,000 English bastards are coming up. I wonder why they hate my town so much. Keep it up, Pouton! We've taken out 60 English. Crap, that was a miss. And they've taken out 12, 22. We're not really up to the 1 to 5 ratio yet. Out of bullets. This is gonna be a hell of a grind. The main problem here though is not gonna be quite entertaining to watch that, is it? I can't really... That looks like it's one of ours. He had blue feathers on. Bloody traitor. We're right now up in... The English have lost about... What is that? 130. And we have lost 22... 30... 35 maybe? So we're closing in on the target. The problem's gonna be when they are forced to retreat. I cannot exactly follow them. I will actually pick... Ah, I can pick this up. Let's drop the mace and pick up the bolts. Now I'm a crossbowman. Crap, the English are actually coming through. The crossbowman needs to give room to everyone else, so crossbows down there. So the others actually managed to get up there, so the macemen can get up and start attacking, because they're now blocking the troops from getting up. This crossbow does not deliver a lot of damage, does it? Keep up the fire! I actually do have pretty good accuracy, so I should be looking at shooting headshots. Were there any more bolts? Nope. Ah, crap, they made it through here. I can actually pick up these bolts. Ah, crap! For the Lord's honor. I bet your lord doesn't have any honor, you English swine! We're looking at about 300 dead English. It sounds like a lot, but then you have to remember there's 2,000 of them out there. 2,500. So even though we've killed this many, or taken out this many, there's still another 2,000 Englishmen ready to assault. I think it's time for the crossbowmen to get back up here. There's some English guys that managed to get through here. Oh! Whoa! We're looking about almost 400 English taken out. We have lost maybe 100. Let's see about getting the crossbowmen up here. Okay then. Oh yeah, I thought it was just gonna hug the wall there, that they weren't clever enough to actually get up. But it looks like they're actually gonna go up into that tower, so we'll put them there. Right, now I give them the order to charge instead. Or if they could maybe hold out here. That's one of ours, I believe. Bloody traitor. Well, there's gonna be a lot of this, so I'll get back once we're able to actually push them off or something. Otherwise, this will go on forever. And it looks like we managed to hold off the first attack, although an English longbow arrow managed to pierce my helmet. So I'm not entirely sure how many men we actually cut down in the end. Let's see the statistics. We lost about half our macemen. I think I had 50 plus. Oh yeah, that would be a lot more then. But this is our men. This is our allied casualties. Our allied casualties, the one stationed in the castle, lost 75% of their force, since there were 100 of them. The English lost 253 longbowmen, 170 killed, 83 wounded, 67 dismounted knights, 60 sergeant-at-arms, 60 billmen, 1 French peasant crossbowman. I knew there was a traitor in there. Actually, wait, that's French knights as well. Bloody traitors. And then all the lords here getting knocked down. Damn, there's a lot of lords. Let's see if I can count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Right, you can guess it's like 20 plus of them. The total losses for them were 700. The force retreat, the assault is over, but the siege continues. Right. We need every man we can get. Regular customer, you're now a regular soldier. Managed to garrison. Maybe if I actually take them, they will be able to recover quickly. More quickly, I should say. There's still a lot of them. We managed to take down about 800. Still leaves twice the numbers. There's still another 800 and more. But I think once we take down the next 800, they'll probably try to escape or flee from this attack. But it's going to be pretty hard to hold on to this town. Quite a blow to the English, though, if they're not able to take this. Ah, they're running away! Only a few remains. They lost hope in the English king. That is, I think, because
Monsieur?
They actually, what happened was that the king lost his face against the Burgundians because they did something. What do you think of Rebel? Prepare to die. We're gonna be able to take down the English king, hopefully, in this battle. The forces are quite equal. Let's move the troops up a bit. We want to move there. Infantry behind, and then the cavalry should move over there. Archivist's guy. I put them because I wanted to do like make a line of them, but there's not enough of them, so it's only one of them. Send them off in the corner. Wait. Are you Archibus? Did I put you on Archibus? Apparently. And let's have the cavalry in the back. The cavalry is just in the back to get the English line to turn around and by that show their backs unprotected. We don't want to get too close to the English line though. Start pulling back a bit. I'm able to field more men though than the English king. Right, let's go for it, actually. Looking at the crossbowmen. They're about to engage anyways. Yeah, here we go, I think. No, there we go. Let's see, can I find the English king here somewhere? Or was he taken down already? The English seem to have lost quite a bit of morale from the battle. Not sure why I was so worried. It looks like the English are running. Archers, I want you up on the hill. Right, infantry, I don't want you to chase after. Oh, I actually hit someone. I don't want you to chase after the enemies running. I haven't actually used the lance more than in the tournaments. I don't seem to be get that couch lance option. This is more like a spear, it seems. Ooh, that's a lot of English archers. The order! Put on! Archers, come forwards! For glory! We have the enemy on the run! Everyone charge! I realize most of our troops are actually archers. So we don't have enough people up on the front line. Send up everything. That would be a very interesting thing to happen if the English come to siege my castle. They fail in the first attempt and they lose hundreds of men. They probably, what did they lose? 800 men or something like that? 790 something? And then they leave their king there. The French charge out of the castle and actually capture the king. Way! If an army of 800, 2,000 English can't stop me, what then can, I ask you? Looks like they're just charging straight ahead. Infantry charge! This time it's even more archers. We'll have the archers actually try to go over here. While the cavalry and the infantry charge forth. And the arquebusier, I want you guys over there. Oh yeah, he is with the arquebusiers. Actually, arquebusiers follow me. Regroup the infantry. Then cavalry to block. The enemy infantry advance over there. I don't think they understand really. How it's done, these guys. You're supposed to do this, and then you go. Right, like this. Pouton! You're supposed to say Pouton every time you fire. My sound's a bit more heavier. We're nowhere close to hitting that guy. Oh, there he goes. You look pretty similar as well. Oh, there's twins! They're twins! They look exactly the same. Right. So we won that battle as well. Winning a lot of big battles in this one. No, they managed to escape. Water will dismount the knights. And wait, do we have English longbowmen somewhere? Yeoman archers. It's close enough. English longbow, there we go. I know I get a lot of money for English longbow. Get about 200, I think. It severely weakened us, but crushing their army like that, giving it such a blow, will probably force them... They'll probably come again, but... Then I'll be more ready, hopefully. And hopefully our king, the French king, will be able to make some sort of peace with the Burgundians and the Bretonians. The Bretonians managed to take back the castle, which wasn't that much of a surprise since we didn't have to didn't put any garrison there, but hopefully, or I should, by the next episode, oh, the English army, since they lost, they became really angry and seems to be setting fire to the entire French countryside. Anyways, by next episode I should hopefully be able to go on the offensive and we should close in on Paris, which is the ultimate goal. For some reason I put that as the goal. So right, hopefully you enjoy this and hopefully I'll see you for the next one. Bye.